going on, YouTube? It is your boy, Sir Jorge, Decorate, bringing you week 3 of the SSBL Season 5. Guys, this week we are facing off none other than Sigh and his Texas Toxtricity. We have another Texas showdown, because I do believe Sigh is from Texas, if I remember correctly, because I think we've talked about this. He's just a really cool logo. I remember when he first showed it. So sort of what's going on now is, for the T-Bulls anyways, I'm just going to be posting like the Poke Paste up in the screen, so right when I've been saying this, been talking about this, there should be a paste or a photo of the team right in front of you, and I'll just break it down right here, right now. So the first thing we're bringing is going to be a weakness policy, autonomized Eggys with Flash Cannon, Shadow Ball, Close Combat, and guess autonomize. We are basically max HP, very very speedy set, and then the rest in special attack in the modest nature. So the idea here is that we sort of bait the Incineroar into a knockoff, and I think we live it, and then or the pulse with an EQ that pops our weakness policy, and basically we get the free KO with the Incineroar at with a close combat, and then everything else does not appreciate a plus Shadow Ball or Flash Cannon. He has a bunch of intimidators, so that's why I didn't opt in for a physical set this week, minus the close combat. I just thought, you know,
might as well.
Next up, we have the Spin Cycle, the Rotom Wash, and we're rocking a more offensive set this week, actually, with Nasty Plot, Hydro Pump, Thunderbolt, and Dark Pulse. The reason behind this is that in the APM, I sort of lost a quarter night because I only brought like physical threats, and I didn't bring my special threats, or my one way to really handle it in the form of my electric Pokemon. So I'm bringing Rotom Wash, and I even decided to bring an offensive set because his ground type is Pillow Swine, and that thing does not appreciate any Hydro Pump, especially if it's a plus 2 after it has Swap. What else? I really like it a lot. The only thing I really stopped this thing is going to be Unaware Fable, and that's okay because I think we deal with that pretty well with our own Eggys Slash. I needed to bring Eggys Slash this week, otherwise we just couldn't break the Fable at all. We had a really hard time dealing with it. Next up we have sort of appearance. We brought them week one. It's gonna be a physically defensive the Dawn, Gastrodon. We're max HP, max defense basically. Is we walk overnight and we stop the member setting up, especially because if it just brings the water move, then we wall it 100% of the time, even if it's like a rest set. So we have clear smog for that. We have surf, we have recover, and what's our last move? Clear smog. It's on the layout, you can see it right now. Next up, we have making her find her own appearance. It's gonna be Fermione, get it, pun. The Delphox was Flame Charge, Life Orb, Flamethrower, Psychic, and Grass Knot. So with this sort of coverage of moves, it does a number to his team. We can take out the Corviknight pretty well. We two-shot, max HP, non-invested, especially invested Suicunes. Pillswine does not appreciate the Grass Knot or the Flamethrower. The only thing that really walls us is going to be that Incineroar. But besides that, Fermione really does put some nice work. It's really our main breaker this week, and I'm hoping she does do some fine work. Speaking of a breaker, we also have Explode this week. So what really Explode does is, in terms of this team, his only resist to us is going to be the Corviknight. And if he's max HP, not specific defenses, we guarantee 3-shot it if he has leftovers. So we do 49% max. We are max HP, or not max HP, max attack modest choice specs. So we are just trying to rip his team. If I learned anything last week is that choice specs explode with boom burst, it's not a joke. And my opponent's really, you know, their lesser setup is really good. Hey, I've been driving all day. They're not gonna appreciate the hits. So yeah. What else? And then finally, we're bringing Falinks, Locust Guard, making their SSBL appearance for the first time ever. We are No Retreat, Close Combat, Iron Head, and Rock Slide. So his team has three intimidators in the form of Incineroar, Mega Manectric, and Masquerade. So the idea here is that sort of debate lead hunters to come out, because we are defiant, so if he lowers our attack, we actually get a, we increase our attack stage by 2 stages. So if we click blue retreat, we go plus 1 everything, and then we'll go plus 2, because, you know, we'll lose 1 because the intimidate, and then we'll gain 2 from the defiant. So, the idea here is to sort of, like, bait out his intimidators, and then basically win from there. Again, the only way that he stops us is going to be unaware of the fable. And that sort of tends me just to run toxic now that I say it. Because if he is unaware. Oh, there it goes. We're Sludge Bomb on the dot. So yeah, I guess there's the team if you guys were quick enough to see it. But yeah, I'm going to cut to where we get in Sun. Alrighty guys, so we have connected with Sigh, so we pretty much get everything we get two, let's see, so he does not bring the Mega Man trick, and he does not bring Pillow Sweat. I am actually A-okay with this, so let me just update the layout. So he brings Tentacruel, which I did expect. So I really like Rotom's matchup this week a lot. The only thing that really like scares me away is Season Sinnoh, especially because it does get Lucy, which I do expect it to carry. Skill Link, Choice Bandit, don't be a turd, OBS. I'm your friend. There we go. And then finally, so he switches out one of his faster Pokemon with, which is, again, fine by me. Oh, wow. You are just cropped above. We're doing it live, folks. We're doing it live. And then, obviously that. See, this didn't happen last week, because I got all the 6 Pokemon correct. So, yeah. Just do that. You know, sometimes you get a really good layout, and then sometimes you just... It just doesn't happen sometimes. Okay, there's Shinsendo. Again, have fun. Bring a link to my opponent. I have not thought of a lead. I think he just leads off with Shinsendo. I think it's a really solid lead for him. He can just go for, like, the knockoff. I'm pretty sure we outspeed Shinsendo at plus 2. Right? I think that's what I EV'd for. Unfortunately, our sort of bait with the Intimidate. Shinsendo knockoff. I always forget that whenever I do calcs, I look at the, we're dead. Okay, so I'm gonna lead off with, Sir Sheath, actually. No, you can lead off with Squidward. I'll just lead off with Snorlax. There isn't that bad of a matchup. There we go, perfect. He could go for Giga Drain. I don't expect him to do that much. Thunderbolt was pretty free here because he does not have a ground type this week. I think I'm gonna go for Thunderbolt. Tentacruel. Do I want it to Tentacruel if we go plus 2? I think he goes to Sinnoh here. That's like the only thing. So if he's not offensive, we two-shot him. If he's not especially defensive, we are pretty, he goes into Clefable, actually, and we do a good chunk to him. I'm going for the Hydro Pump, and we miss. He goes for Softball, okay. I'm going for a Nasty Plot here. I don't know what he goes for. There's a Moon Blast, okay, that does a lot to me. So, we could risk Kamek. Okay, he goes unaware. Perfect. So we are going to knock out the Cliff Table immediately. That's honestly the one thing that was getting in the way for us. Here, he's going to go for the, he's going for the Ballista here. Yeah, he's going for the Ballista here. We can go into Fermione, but I don't like that too much. Knockoff's actually pretty free for him as well. I'm just gonna go into Corvus are at least useful. We need Rotom to defeat the Corviknight and the Incineroar and the Squidward, so... Really? I'm just going to Dropta, see what he looks for. He gets full of seed. Okay, that's a new ancient medicine now. And I think... Yeah. That looks like Charizard damage to me. Sentinel. Or Sentinel, whatever you want to pronounce it. Explode. Yeah, he's Swift Banded. Okay, so I'm gonna switch out here and go to Toxtricity. Look at that lovely damage. Here I'm just gonna go for the Autonomize. Actually, who does he go into? He probably goes into Tentacle. Okay. I kind of wish I went for the close combat there. We're minus one. But the thing is, the one thing that sort of we were trying to like, I don't think we're going to be able to get our weakness policy to pop. It's like the one thing. So do we just sack off? Do we sack off our... Our Eggys Flash. If he's bulky, we do about half. We could also just sack up Explode. But I really like... No, I'm gonna sack up Explode here. As he goes for knockoff, yeah. Okay. So I'm gonna go into Locust Guard. I do not know what his switch into this thing is. I don't know what to take A's in Headbutt, or, you know. Probably. Let's go for the close combat, see what his switch is. Suicune, okay. This is so Danny. Pretty sure we could live a Skull at neutral. So I'm gonna go for the number three, actually. And this close climate should be a bop. No! Oh, we got a high roll that in that case. Okay. Okay, that's fine. So, damn! That was definitely a roll then. Wait, so... Rip the boys, yeah. I thought that would kill. That sucks. You hate to see it, folks. We can just go back into, Suicide. He does not have a switch into this thing anymore. And he has two choices. Give me, Suicune, or something takes a Thunderbolt. I really wish we had full switch here. Yeah, he's an EMS Pokemon. So, Suicune's not down. He's one of our bulkier Pokemon. We're getting, you know, health as we speak. Again, our switch into Suicune is kind of obvious. So, I think he goes for the knockoff here. Our Gastrodon's role is really belittled since the fact, you know, it goes for knockoff. Perfect. I'm gonna go for the recover. He goes cynical. Okay. I can't touch this thing at all. And unfortunately, we don't have a switch in. So, I'm just gonna go for a Scald and hope to get a burn. Okay, I don't mind because the only Pokemon that would get affected is Hermione. As he goes for Sludge Wave, I'm expecting the Incineroar to come in. So we'll go ahead to Dawn. Nope. And when you get the Storm Drain boost, nice it. Sludge Wave, we can recover this damage off. I'm gonna go for the recover here. So we are definitely doing stall. We're stalling out a bit here. So I gotta recover twice. Actually, it looks like this is not a winning trade for me. So typical. Like, Rotom can definitely win here. If he locks himself into, like, knockoff. If we get the burn here, that'd be great. So we can counteract his leftovers. Where's the burn when you need it, man? I'm gonna go for the recover here. I'm gonna sack off the Dawn. As crazy as it seems. Because I'm gonna go into Sir Cheese and use close combat twice to kill off the Incineroar. And for Miney just basically has a better chance of winning. Now he has to decide whether or not Skull. Yeah, he's because we're knock off. At least not the burn. Sucks. But, that means we actually could set up with Autonomize Aegis Slash now. So he gets that 50-50 wrong. Using the Corviknight. We are very speedy, Rotom, so I'm not afraid of this thing at all. I'm just going for the Scald. Yo, the Dawn putting in some work! Let's get it! Can we get a second burn? Oh, yeah! I just sacked this thing off. He could definitely have Roost. But there's no need for me to, like, go into, like, for mining. Like, if I switch out, I basically suck, lose a mod. Because we are max speed Rotom. Okay, he probably goes for the boost here. If I lose Rotom here, then I lose. Basically. Do we need Gastro? Not really. I'm sacking out the Dawn. Like, I'm not gonna switch out until he, you know, does not click bulk up. It's a roost. Okay. Us getting that Storm Drain boost really matters a lot. We are playing sort of the... So... Yeah, so he's probably max HP, max speed. And him getting that burn is really big. So, again, I'm just giving him... I'm giving him the Dawn, essentially. Power trip. Okay. Again, we just go into Rotom Wash and we just click T-Bolt. So, yeah. honestly, Rotom on his own just wins. I'm gonna cycle for Miney. Do we leave a bullet seed now? Hold up. So Rotom Wash. Let's see. Cincinnati. Better. So we got close combat twice basically now. His 50-50s have not been on point today. There's Incineroar. And then we get the crit. I don't think that mattered at all. Because we are pretty speedy. I'd sack off Hermione now. Actually, do we sack off Aegis Slash or do we sack off, Delphox? Is Psyshock too atypical? We just sack off Sushi Fear. I'm with the Shadow Ball. Ooh! Look at that! You love to see it. He just basically guessed me for switch out. I should have gone Autonomize. We would have won. Wait, what? If we clicked. Alright, so I'm pretty sure that's game now. Yeah. It's basically GG. Does the Dawn? No, not yet. We go to Spin Cycle, because we love the hit no matter what. That's GG. Rotom's gonna tie up that game for us. We are gonna move on 2-1. Good game to my opponent, Sigh. That was definitely an interesting battle. If we connected the Hydro Pump at the beginning, then we would have been in a better position. Cool, we're gonna win a nice 2-0 here. Falinks not getting that kill definitely sucked. I think if... So, with the team builder, I forgot to mention this in the beginning. I had a hard time building these, because I would add a Mon, I'd take a Mon out. But anyways, we're gonna win a nice 2-0 there. It's gold. It's really big, the burn. We finally got it, though. We were spamming it. Gets it to the pool. We didn't get it, but we got it on the Cover Knight and the Cincinnati, which I think was much more important. But anyways, I'm gonna wrap things up here. Your Falinks de Guadalajara are gonna move on 2-1. I think I just said that Eggys earlier. I'm at Falinks de Guadalajara. And you do know me as a quick break. Make sure you're using the word of an Eggy. And we will catch you guys for week 4 of the SSBL. See you then. Bye bye!